2020 has been a difficult year for all of us, but it has given us time to reflect on the wonderful memories of past seasons at the Cape Playhouse. For more than 20 years, the Playhouse has been an integral part of our lives. We've had the opportunity to see world-class plays and musical productions in a small village here on Cape Cod.
We've also had the privilege to meet Broadway actors, directors, and production teams. We have welcomed many of them into our home, and they have become like family. This Thanksgiving, we are thankful for the relationships we have formed because of our ties to the Cape Playhouse. We look forward to many more summer seasons and making more memories. We want to wish everyone a happy Thanksgiving.
Testa, and I have to say that in 2018, I had the great good fortune to play Weezer in the Cape Playhouse's production of Steel Magnolias. It was so wonderful. I had never been to the Cape Playhouse. I had never worked there. It was gorgeous. It's a gorgeous theater. I had a wonderful time. It was so much fun. For me, it was like looking in a mirror playing that character, and it was tremendous, and it's a wonderful place, and I look forward to someday working there again. So it's a great memory for me. It was 2018. It was 2 years ago. Oh my God, what a different time.
Hello, everyone. I'm Michael Rader, producing artistic director of the Cape Playhouse, and a very special Thanksgiving welcome to you and our Behind the Playhouse Curtain broadcast. So grab your glass of wine, I'm having a hot apple cider here with a little bit of bourbon. Grab those because we have a really amazing special broadcast for you. Tonight, we're coming to you from all over the country as we have invited some really special actors, musicians, designers to join us and sharing their favorite Cape Playhouse memories and why they are thankful for their time with us. We're also gonna have some behind the scenes special messages coming from alumni and some community members that we'll be bringing you throughout the broadcast.
So it's been a weird year. I've been raising chickens in my backyard during the pandemic. All that being said, there's still a lot to be thankful for. One of those things was my time at the Cape Playhouse. Doing noises off. To be able to get out of the city in the heat of the summer and go to the Cape, where I can go to the beach in the afternoon and do a show at one of America's most historic and beautiful theaters at night, like that's a dream come true. And I got to do it with one of my favorite casts of all time. It's the level of talent the Cape brings is just extraordinary. And the audiences are some of the warmest and most generous I've ever got to perform for. So being able to do noises off was a highlight of my 2019. And I am looking forward to going back there and doing another show once this is all over. All right. Happy Thanksgiving, everybody. Stay safe out there.
Hi, I'm Ben Chavez, and I'm so thankful to have had the opportunity to perform at the Cape Playhouse. It was such an honor to play at one of the founding theaters of summer stock in America. That blew my mind from the get-go. And I think my favorite memory was one day before the show, I went backstage just to prepare. And when you look around backstage at the Cape Playhouse, there are posters from all of the shows that have happened in the past decades. And to see so many faces that I have idolized and looked up to and admired throughout my life. Huge historic names, Julie Andrews, Betty Davis, Gertrude Lawrence. I love Art Carney. His is one of the posters that caught my eye. To know that I got to be on a stage that they had graced during their careers It makes you feel pretty special. And I just remember looking out into the audience and breathing in into the space and feeling all of those names there up on stage with me. And so I'm just so thankful to have had that experience. Happy Thanksgiving.
Thanksgiving for me is one of my all-time favorite holidays of the year. And I feel like this year more than ever, it doesn't hurt to spend some time just giving thanks for the gift of theater and the Cape Playhouse. So I'm so thrilled to have these amazing individuals joining us today to remind us how lucky we are to have this amazing theater in our backyard. So without further ado, I'm going to introduce them all first because there's a few of them, and then we'll welcome everybody. So we have our amazing resident music director, Garrett Taylor, joining us, director and choreographer, Jason Sparks, a star from our recent production of A Chorus Line, Kevin Kurtis, our very own Bloody Mary, Yvonne Strumecki, our scenic designer, mastermind, David Arsenault, the hilariously gifted actor, Steven DeRosa, and the incomparable Tony-nominated star, Miss Allison Fraser. Hello, friend.
Hi.
Hi.
Happy Thanksgiving, everyone.
Happy Thanksgiving.
Happy Thanksgiving.
Oh, it's so wonderful to see you all. And I'm sure our community is so happy to see you too. Actually, Garrett, you might have to turn around because our patrons are used to seeing just the back of your head.
Oh, yeah.
Right. There's Garrett. There we go. I want to know about your favorite memories. Some of you have done lots of things at the Playhouse. Some of you have just started your time with us. But Garrett, you've done quite a few shows. And just so our patrons know, you are the resident music director. That doesn't mean you can just conduct the orchestras, but you put a significant amount of work in preparations and orchestrating and making those amazing scores like South Pacific and A Chorus Line, sound gorgeous in our theater. So what's one of your favorite memories? Doesn't have to be your favorite.
Oh gosh, so many favorite memories. But I do have to say, what I will never forget is the first time walking onto the grounds and being taken backstage and like looking up at the old wooden slats with all the posters from all the previous shows from, gosh, so many years before, and just the feeling, the energy, and knowing that now I get to be even a small little piece of the history and the magic. Honestly, it sounds so cheesy, but it gives me chills. And just every time walking in there, I feel so grateful that I get to be even a small part of the 94, 95 years of that theater. Mm-hmm. And to think about the people that have tread those boards, right? And been in that space, and all of the audience members, the stories and the magic, and how the people, the audiences have been transported from the magic and the art that is theater at the Cape Playhouse is just, honestly, so that's really my favorite memory. Obviously, lots of great memories over the summers have been made there, but I'll never forget the first time going there and feeling the magic.
Hi, Arthur Bukopoulos here. I've been a woodwind player in the pit at the Cape Playhouse for about 6 or 7 years, and I just wanted to say a little bit about it. When I first got the gig there, I thought, wow, great, another gig. And I quickly found out that it wasn't just another gig. It's a wonderful place to play, a wonderful place to be. And, you know, everything from the way it's run, the people that run it, behind the scenes, the actors. I think the music's very good. And the crowd that comes is, they're so happy and they talk to you. It's very nice. It's a great place to be. Funny, my family stopped coming to my gigs many years ago, but this one they make sure they come to every summer, and they love it. I love it. I think you'll love it too. See you there.
Yvonne and Kevin, you were in South Pacific, Kevin, you were in Chorus Line, iconic shows that are in some ways like I consider to be big. Like these are vast, big shows, whether we're dealing with big issues or big just scenically or in their aesthetic. What was your experience? And you've both worked on the show. Yvonne, you've done, you've done 1,000 productions. Kevin, you've done 1,000 productions of A Chorus Line. What was it like for you guys coming into like the Cape space, a building that's 100 and some years old? The stage is 95 years old. You know, it's a more intimate different setting. We don't necessarily always have the bells and whistles. But what was it like? What was it like for you guys?
I actually really love it. I don't, as much as I like singing in big spaces because my voice carries, I actually really love the smaller spaces because you can really connect to the audience that's right there in front of you, and you can connect much easier to people that are on stage with you. And that's what really makes a show is that connection. So CAPE has definitely been like one of my top ever theaters to have sung in. So.
Yeah, what's funny is like, you know, Chorus Line, I think like having a small space like works so much better. Like we could actually see Zach in the back of the theater. Mm. So, you know, he was really in the scene with us. Yeah, like I so loved doing it in that space. And Joyce did all new staging and choreography. Mm. So, I mean, even though I've done like 10 billion productions, like it was so new.
People were quick changing and about to come on for finale. And we do have two swings that are one swings. They just stand by to make sure there's a spot filled if somebody didn't make their quick change. And I was standing there paging the curtain for the people to like make their entrances, and someone got their zipper stuck. And we were like, oh my goodness, is Richard going on? This is Richard, it was another swing. And he got to go on, and it was just, it was crazy. Our dance caption just pushed him on and he knew everything, and it was theater magic.
I'm thankful for the resilience of the Cape Playhouse. Last summer when taking a Chorus Line, a tornado hit Cape Cod. And I've been coming to Cape Cod for maybe 20 years now, and I've never seen a tornado happen here. So major power outages. But the staff continued working tirelessly to get generators and to keep working on the show. Even our first preview we did in one cue light, and the audience still gave a standing ovation because they were so impressed with the work going on at this playhouse. And then lo and behold, opening night, during the curtain speech, the lights came back on. And it was theater magic. And I just can't wait for that to happen again.
David and Jason, what's it like creating in our space? I mean, again, a unique space. Jason, we talked about it like for American in Paris, like creating this massive ballet in an intimate space. And David, you certainly have the challenge of like, I'm sure you love when I call and say, hey, we're going to do this amazingly huge production and I need you to do it on a postage stamp. So let's make it work. What's it like for you guys as being creatives in that environment?
What I love about the Cape specifically is that everybody, like, it's like you step on campus at the Cape and all of a sudden every single person is a yes person. So you could be like, I have this idea that I want someone flying in from this on fire as fireworks go off behind them. And everyone kind of gathers around, like, let's figure out how to make this happen. It's so rare, I feel like, today in today's world, but everyone is so creative at the Cape and so on board so quickly that everyone surrounds you and trying to figure out how do we best accomplish this. It does not happen everywhere, and it happens at the Cape.
Hi, my name is Maddie Scher, and I feel super grateful to have been a part of the cast of Gypsy in the summer of 2017 with the Cape Playhouse. One of my favorite memories from the show was after we finished all of our rehearsals in New York City, we traveled up to Cape Cod where we had a really fun and welcoming barbecue with all of the cast and crewmates. It was a really great opportunity just to kind of relax and get to know everyone on a more personal level. It's definitely a memory I will cherish forever, and I want to thank the Cape Playhouse, and I hope to return back one day soon. Bye!
Hi, I'm Sasha Capitani. I was in Gypsy at the Cape Playhouse in the summer of 2017. I'm so thankful for all the people that I met in that show. It was such a warm, welcoming community, and some of the people I still talk to today.
Hi, Cape Playhouse. I'm Garrett Ha, and I played Tulsa in the 2017 production of Gypsy, starring Julia Murney, and it remains one of my favorite theater experiences to date. I grew up in Massachusetts and New Hampshire and spent my summers in Cape Cod, so performing at the Playhouse was always a huge goal of mine. So getting to do so in my favorite musical, in my dream role, and having family members and friends from close by able to come see it was just really, really special to me. I really miss live theater, and I'm hopeful that it's coming back sooner than we think. I can't wait to be back on stage again and back in an audience, opening up a playbill and hearing the orchestra tune up. Until then, stay well, stay safe, and have a happy Thanksgiving and happy holidays.
I was ironically going to say the exact same thing in a different way, in that no one ever says no to me when I go there. So I sort of, I get to go with my wildest imagination and expand. And I sort of have a reputation for pushing things to their limits because I like height, I like volume, and there's not a lot of that at the Cape. So I spend a lot of time like pushing to literally the limits of the building and finding unique ways to sort of deal with the random pieces of wood sticking out everywhere backstage. It's but the team is so gung-ho about getting it done that it's, you know, it's, you always come out with an incredible product that you didn't think you'd be able to.
Hi, I'm Janine Lamana, and I made my Cape Playhouse debut last summer in a play called Noises Off. It's a drama, not very funny. Not really sure why the audience laughed so much. But I just wanted to say how grateful I am to the artistic staff and the crew and the board of directors and the town of Dennis and the theater patrons for literally welcoming us from the moment we got there to the moment we left. I mean, this is a really special place, and not just because of all the people that have preceded us, but because of the people that are there now. So thank you so much for welcoming my family to yours. And I hope this finds everyone happy and healthy this holiday season. And I am so looking forward to what the Cape Playhouse does next. I know it's going to be amazing. All right. All the best.
There are definitely angels there. I don't know if you believe in that, but go to the Cape Playhouse and you'll start to believe, because it's a spiritual experience, and little things surprise you. You feel the everyone who works there. It's so refreshing to have interns and ushers and everyone who's involved also feeling the spirit of the Playhouse.
Hi, you guys. I'm so, so grateful for the Cape Playhouse. I am so grateful for the people I've met and worked with every summer. One summer, sometimes they come back to see a show, and it's great to say hi. And getting to know the people of Cape Cod, coming to see every show, always talking about, oh, I loved this show and this actor, and just being able to feel like, oh, I know that person, you can reach out to them. It's such a great place to be, and I am so, so, so grateful for my time at the Cape Playhouse.
I love the Playhouse to death. It's like the number one thing I look forward to every summer is going back to the Playhouse and seeing my coworkers again, who are like a family to me, getting to interact with the community, whether they're returning patrons or new faces. I can't imagine being anywhere else other than the Cape Playhouse. I'm very thankful for it, period.
Playhouse is a part of our American cultural history. And for a theater actor, it's like, you know, it really is soul nourishing, for lack of a better word. Even though it was just a joyful experience, and I got to work with some very silly, funny people, and had moments in the shows where I got to, where my only job was to try to see if I could make somebody else laugh on stage, and that is one of my greatest joys. So I feel, you know, I think, and the other weird thing about this is that, not so weird about it, but is that I've never, let me not jinx it, let me knock on wood, knocking, but I've never heard an actor say, ugh, I went to the Cape Playhouse, or oh, don't go there. It's usually the opposite. Like, stage managers and actors, when you talk about the Cape Playhouse, it's like you're part of this like society of, you know, a fraternity or sorority where you're like, oh, you went to the Cape? Oh my God, you're so lucky, you're gonna go there, you're gonna go to the beach, underground bakery, get their breakfast sandwich.
Hi, I'm Susan Wands, and I got to be in Deathtrap in 2019 at the Cape Playhouse, and it was a highlight of my life. Not only was the work on stage fantastic, but the crew, the front of the house, and the audiences were just absolutely spectacular. And every friend that we had to come to see a show at the Playhouse, especially a lot of our friends who'd never been there before, said they couldn't wait to come back again. It's just one of those special places that you can come back to again and again. So thank you for your support. We look for many more years of the wonderful productions at the Cape Playhouse.
Hi, this is Pam Hunt saying hello and happy Thanksgiving to everybody. I am so grateful for my time spent at the Cape. It was a place I always wanted to work, and I've been lucky to do about 20 seasons. It's a miraculous place. It is the longest running summer professional theater in the United States. And the greatest things I like about it are being on Cape Cod, the wonderful cast and people behind the scenes. It's a blessing. So here's to the next season and rock on, Michael.
Allison, you were new. You were brand new to the Playhouse too. What was that like for you? You pull up on the grounds and you see this historic old theater. Was it what you anticipated? What was that like?
Well, I had a very personal reaction to it because my uncle Larry was a great, great theater lover. I mean, he was the type of guy that would come to New York and go to 9 shows in 7 days. He was just devoted. And he was a huge, huge Gertrude Lawrence fan. And he was an elderly gay guy. But he was madly in love with Gertrude Lawrence. He had two dogs named Gertie at different times in his life. And I remember he took me to her grave. Is it up in Massachusetts, right?
Upton.
Mm-hmm. Up in Upton. And I walked into that room, and he would have been so thrilled, because when I walked into the theater and realized, oh, my God, I'm certainly not the lead in this play, but I got the Gertrude Lawrence dressing room, and I had this visceral reaction. I just started crying because I wish that Larry had been alive long enough to come and see me and to come and sit in the Gertie Lawrence dressing room, which really does feel like it still has her spirit there, and with the blue hydrangeas. And I mean, I'm sorry, but every once in a while, I'd fluff the pillow on that recamier, and I'd come back in, and someone had been sitting there, and nobody was going into the room, okay? So I'm not sure if it was Larry tagging on or Gertie, but it was a slim-hipped person, so I'm thinking it was Gertie.
Hey there. So one of my favorite memories from Cape Playhouse was probably the first time I'd ever walked backstage. There is this little hallway filled with pictures of famous actors who've worked at the theater over the years. And there's a picture of Ginger Rogers and Gertrude Lawrence and a bunch of other stars. And I remember the first time I saw that, I thought, wow, it really puts into perspective the long history that the theater has shared with the Cape. And I'm thankful that I was able to just spend a little chunk of my summer there, because it truly is a magical place. And I hope that the residents on the Cape will continue to enjoy many, many years of such wonderful high caliber theater.
Well, I'll mention, just because you said it, Michael, the performing in the show. I hung my hat up as a performer, God, 10 years ago. I've been been able to pursue directing and choreographing, which was just my dream. Never thought I'd perform again in my life. Never, never, never. It's not my strength. Shouldn't be doing it. Long story short, we're doing Altar Boys, and about a week into the run, and they're only 2-week run, so we're halfway through, one of the Altar Boys has appendicitis and needs to have an emergency appendectomy.
And we don't have understudies.
No understudies. You know, it's a 2-week run. What are we going to do?
Right.
I was in Florida working on another show, and I loved the Cape so much and loved that group of actors so much. So it's like, all right, I gotta go dust off those dancing shoes, and I need to go into the show. And so I wrote the lyrics all up and down my arm. So I would literally move it, look at them, move it back down. But what was so cool about it, and what was so fun about it, is going back to even just that yes thing, is I, you know, touched down in Boston, and immediately someone was there, put me in a car, got me, you know, right to the Cape. And then whether it was costumes, light, whatever department it was, like, surrounded me to take care of me, to say, and as a director and as a choreographer, we're doing that so often for so many other people. Mm-hmm. We're like, I got you. That's what we're always saying is, don't worry, I got you. And to have not just the actors, not just the stage management, not just, but an entire community look at you and say, now we got you, was so moving. And it just like my faith in theater, not that it needed to be renewed, but it was just like, oh, this is why we do it. This is what it's about. I was terrified, and I'm sure it was terrible, but the show kept going. So that's really important.
You were not terrible. And Kevin, equally as crazy. Holy cow.
Let's talk about it.
Do we have to?
Look, I mean, it was a nightmare, but I secretly loved it. I like had a ball during the tornado.
Yeah.
It's so exciting. Like whenever something happens that's unexpected in theater, I all of a sudden kind of perk up and I'm like, I'm loving this.
One of the most unforgettable moments I've ever had was when we were in the tech process for A Chorus Line. And that's when a tornado hit Cape Cod for the first time in over 100 years. And our power went out completely. And we did our entire tech process without power. We did our first preview somehow without power. And then opening night was coming and we still didn't have power. But the Cape Playhouse said, you know what? People need this right now. We're gonna make it work. We're gonna make it happen. We're gonna have this show and this opening night. And so we were all gathered in the theater for opening night and it was minutes before the first performance was supposed to start. And within seconds of the curtain going up, the lights came on and the power came back on and you just heard it. And then the entire audience and the company backstage, we all erupted at the same time in this amazing cheer and applause because the power was on. And it was just one of those magical opening night moments that you can only imagine happening. And I just have to say thank you.
Well, I think it was so good for our company though. Cause I think like a lot of times when it's a quick tech process, you get into the space, you get under the lights, you get in the costume, you're on the set, and all of a sudden you're in like performance. It's easy to just like go into performance mode. But because like we didn't have, you know, the lights and like the whole sound and the this and the that, it like forced us to like really just rely on what we did in the studio. Right. You know, so like I feel like it really like brought our company together in like a really like strong way.
Right.
And I have to say that particular company, like we were ready, I feel like in a week. It was kind of insane. And it was such an intense process. So it was like, there was no better company for something like that to happen to. You know what I mean? They were so ready and so professional and such like kind, caring people, just like came together and everybody did what they had to do and theater magic happened. Mm-hmm. Once again, yeah. There's that word.
A favorite memory, I don't know if anybody was there for opening night, but it was in the middle of this big storm, the power had been out and we were at places, everyone was behind the curtain and ready to do the show, just, you know, with house lights, we're gonna make it work. And then Michael's giving his speech and the power comes on at that moment. I mean, if that isn't just theater magic, I don't know what is. I miss you, Kate Playhouse. I hope to see you soon. Happy holidays.
David, what about you? You've done probably more shows than anybody here at the Playhouse. Do you have any iconic memories that stick out to you or?
I mean, similar, yeah, it's similar to what Jason said is when I had to go on for Bloody Mary in Texas. I don't know that I can pinpoint any specific memories because over the course of 7 shows, they all sort of blur together over at a certain point. But there are 2 things I love. I love that there's the cookout on the first day that the cast is there. That's my absolute favorite. Like burgers outside, everybody's there. Like there's no stress yet. Like you haven't got like
right.
No one realizes like the set's not painted yet, so it's all good. Which actually has never happened, but maybe once, but a long time ago. But the other thing is, or my other favorite memory is just like being in the room with everybody, like putting that show together in so little time. Like it's all hands on deck. Everyone is solving every problem. Like it forces you to be engaged in a way that is different from other theaters because you don't have a week of tech and 3 previews. Like it has to be all hands on deck all the time. And that feeling of camaraderie and like, let's get it done. Like no matter what, like, you know, and it leads to sleepless nights, but at the end, like when that curtain goes up on opening night, it's always worth it. Like it's so impressive what you can do in such a short amount of time when everyone's on the same plane.
Hi, I'm Dwayne Boutte.
and I had the great pleasure of playing Professor Plum in Clue live on stage a couple of summers ago. To be backstage and see all those posters of Art Carney and Jessica Tandy and Tallulah Bankhead and Jean Stapleton, who I have admired my whole life and wish I could have met at some point in my life or her life. But there I am working on that same stage, those same boards, and it was an honor and a treat, and I still can't believe it in some ways. So thank you, Cape Playhouse, and thank you, Cape Cod.
Your designs last year of, I'm just thinking off the top of my head, of Once and Boyz Is Off were just gorgeous. I mean, incredible. There used to be this tradition in the Playhouse many, many, many years ago with our designers, Helen and Herb Pond, who with their sets were known for, like, when the curtain went up, getting applause. And you're consistently a designer who gets applause when that curtain go up. And consistently last year with those shows, the curtain would go up. I mean, it didn't go up on Once, but like for Noises Off, the curtain would go up when the show started. And I loved like doing my curtain speech, going off stage, the show starting, the curtain going up, and I would be back in the green room and I consistently would hear applause, applause, applause. And then
but that's a testament to the crew as well. Like I can put it all on paper, but yeah. I'm only one element in a vast machine. So it's like, I'm more than anything, I'm thankful for the people of the Cape, and, you know, and especially like Dan Whiting, who was the production manager for several years and the technical director who brought my visions to life and who know, probably lost more sleep than I did by not saying no to me, but I'm endlessly grateful.
Hi everybody, I'm John Shear. Happy Thanksgiving. Thanksgiving is my favorite holiday and the Cape Playhouse is my favorite theater. I've been coming there since 1986. I was 12. I love coming to the Cape Playhouse for so many reasons. I love the history of the theater. I love the work that we do there. I love Chapin Beach and Captain Frosty's and riding my bike around town. But I think something that I love the most is after the show, going over to the Scargo Cafe and having a glass of wine and getting to talk with the audience members who've just seen the show, who are always so great. And they say, hey, I saw you in this, or I saw you in that, or I saw you in Unnecessary Farce. And it's just so great to have a home away from home during the summertime. It's such a beautiful place. And I know that this year has been tough, but I know that Michael has great things in store for this season. So keep the faith, stay healthy, and happy Thanksgiving.
I remember Nancy Opal on the sofa in Clue, and there was a moment where she had to just collapse, but it took about 11 or 12 seconds before she actually collapsed and rolled off of the sofa and onto the floor. And just every night it was just we were all on that show Clue, we were all having such fun. And there was the funny thing about as fun as the shows were, like I got to play an androgynous person in Sylvia, and just figuring out what that wig was going to be, and then the costume, that was the joy. But for me, what made the Cape Playhouse so even more fun was just like when Michael Rader would come on and make some cocktails, you know, and we'd all, after the show, or we'd all get to sit around the fire pit, or we all get to just sit in the backyard and talk. And I mean, you know, that's one of the things that all of us, I think, are missing so much from the theater, and is that sense of, you know, like I forgot
community.
That first day cookout when you're all together and you feel like you're part of, you know, this instant family that you make in theater all the time, and you know, you miss that, I can't explain it. I know the Cape is just designed for it, and it has a great, and it comes together. And I do think, I know the check is in the mail, but I need a bonus because of COVID. So, but I really do think a lot of it comes from the top, and I think Michael and Leslie too, but especially Michael. At the end of the day, let's have a cheers to Mr. Rader, because I think that, you know, his love and spirit
Thank you.
Trickles down. I'll never forget. I was just like, who's that guy fixing the air conditioner? It's half hour. And I was like, and they're like, that's Michael. Oh, darling, what are you doing? He's like, somebody's got to do it. I was at Home Depot at 5 a.m. or whatever. I'm like, well, that's an artistic director. Do you know what I mean? And that's the cape.
Hey there, this is Jillian Lewis. I was there at Cape Playhouse for a production of Steel Magnolias in 2018. I had a wonderful time on that production. It was just a really hilarious group of artists and comedians just cracking each other up on stage every night. A really incredible team we had in place for that show, just creative and hardworking and really wonderful. And the whole staff there at Cape Playhouse just made it a really good experience. I particularly love coming off stage every night and seeing the pictures and reading the stories of all of the incredible artists who had performed there over the years. So thank you, Cape Playhouse, for a wonderful theatrical experience, for a really wonderful summer, and also for everything you do for our theater community. Thank you. Be well. Stay safe.
Thank you to the Cape Playhouse and all the wonderful people connected with this historic, vibrant theater. You inspire with creativity and community. Looking forward to many bright seasons ahead.
From us, from the Cape Playhouse, from our community and patrons, we're incredibly thankful for each and every one of you guys for everything you brought to the theater. And as I think it was Garrett who said it, you know, for whatever time we all have in that on those boards at that theater, I'm honored to have shared that space with you and to got to have you there and to create with you and it's, you're all special to me, so thank you.
Thank you.
We love you.
So one thing I always like to do before we end is just go around and say one word that describes the Playhouse, and it can be what you've always thought of the Playhouse or what this conversation has brought up. We'll just go around one at a time. And one word that I'm going to focus on today based on this conversation is magic. Garrett?
Legendary.
Allison?
Love.
Steven?
Angels.
Aw. Yvonne?
Home.
Jason?
Community.
David?
History.
And Kevin, was that it?
Yeah. What's my second? Community. Did somebody say that? Somebody said that.
You can reuse community.
History, community. Yeah.
Well, thank you to all of you. I hope you have a wonderful, wonderful Thanksgiving. I'm cheersing to Uncle Larry and Gertie and each and every one of you. I hope you have a wonderful Thanksgiving from the Cape Playhouse and hope to have you all back very, very soon.
Happy Thanksgiving.
Happy Thanksgiving.
Ooh, that sounds good, doesn't it?
Well, I hope you enjoyed going behind the scenes with us today. We'll be back again next Monday at 5 p.m. for Behind the Playhouse Curtain. Until then, from all of us at the Cape Playhouse, we wish you a really wonderful and safe and healthy Thanksgiving. And we look forward to seeing you again soon. Take care.
Well, Carolyn, here we are at the Cape Playhouse.
Gary, I miss it so much.
I do too. Let's just go inside and soak in some memories.
What a great idea. Oh, I think that's Gertrude Lawrence over there.
Hey, look at that handsome couple in the loge. They're probably somebody famous. So, Carolyn, what are some of your favorite shows?
Definitely Chorus Line, Gary. You know, I saw it on Broadway in the 80s and it was wonderful, but here at the Cape Playhouse, we were able to see those dance numbers up real close from the loge and it was electrifying. How about you?
I'm always fascinated by the innovative set design. Sets add so much to my enjoyment. That's a good one. Oh yeah, I love that one too.
I love the energy on opening night. And then at the Scargo Cafe after party, we always sat at that table for two by the door. When the actors arrived, we clapped and cheered for them, and they were so surprised and touched.
Right, you know, I really like the talkbacks.
Oh, that was wonderful, being able to chat with the cast and the crews about the shows, and it was so much fun seeing Cape Cod through their eyes.
Yeah, I miss it, but you know what? I'm really looking forward to getting season tickets for the 2021 season.
Or 2022. But whenever that is, the show will go on.
We miss you, Cape Playhouse.